Today we are going to start the fifth poem of our book Honeysuckle, that is Where Do All the Teachers Go? Class, as we all know that teachers are very special for their students or the students who start their initial stages, who start education in their initial stages. Suppose it's a primary student who has taken admission in LKG or nursery class. For him, his teacher or her teacher is like her next mother or second mother, and they wonder, they treat their teacher as a special person. They think their teacher is not like ordinary people. These are a kind of a special person. So class, let's read the poem, what's inside it, and then I will explain you the poem. Listen it carefully, class. Where do all teachers go? When it's 4 o'clock, do they live in houses? Do they wash their socks? Do they wear pajamas? And do they watch TV? And do they pick their noses? And the same as you and me, do they live with other people? Have they mums and dads? And were they ever children? And were they ever bad? Did they ever never spelt right? Did they ever make mistakes? Were they punished in the corner if they pinched the chocolate flakes? Did they ever lose their hymn books? Did they ever leave their greens? Did they scribble on their desktop? Did they wear old dirty jeans? I'll follow one back home today. I'll find out what they do. Then I'll put it in a poem that they can read to you. So this poem was written by Peter Dixon. The poet of this poem is Peter Dixon. And here he describes, are the teachers equally, do the teachers work, live, and do their things like ordinary people? Suppose the poet wonders, and he finally gives a conclusion that he would follow one of his teachers, and he would, after watching what his teacher or her teacher does after leaving the home, leaving the school, he would put it in a line. He will make or frame a poem. Then he'll make one of his teachers read the poem loudly in front of all the students. So class, let's look at the explanation of this poem. In the first para, the poet describes, where do all the teachers go when it's 4 o'clock? Means, where do all the teachers go after the school is over, when the school is over at 4 o'clock? Do they also live in houses like the houses which we live in? And do they also wash their socks, which smells very bad during the whole days because of wearing these socks for whole day? Then he says, do they wear pajamas and do they watch TVs? The poet says, after reaching home, do they also wear comfortable clothes like t-shirts and pajamas, and do they also watch TV for getting some relax and entertainment? And he says, do they also pick their noses? Do they also clean their noses with the help of fingers or some hanky, just like ordinary people like we and other students do? In third para, the poet says, do they also live in families? Do they also have families? Do they also have fathers and mothers? And when they were children, were they also misbehaving? Were they also very bad and disciplined? Now, the fourth para, he says, had they ever spelled any spelling wrong? Have they ever done any mistake? Were they mischievous or naughty when they were child? And were they punished for taking out the chocolate flakes from some dishes? Were they very naughty in their childhoods? Now, the poet says, did they ever lose their hymn books? When they were young, when they were children like us, have they ever lost their rhyme book or poem book? And have they ever, had they poet says, had they ever left their green vegetables in pits because they did not like to eat those green vegetables. And he said, while sitting in their class and studying, have they also scribbled their desktops? Okay, scribble means होता है खुरचना. Okay, have they also scribbled their desktops? And do they wear? Had they also worn dirty old jeans in their youth days or when they were child? Now, in the last concluding para, the poet says, today I will follow one of my teacher to see what they do after leaving the school, and when I will observe everything about my teacher, I will frame a poem, I will write down a poem and make my teacher read the poem loudly in front of whole class. So class, this was the explanation of the chapter. Now what you have to do at home is, you have to write down the poem, neatly in your fair notebooks. Parents or some